Hello and welcome, our blood viewers, to RTD's News English Edition. As usual, we begin tonight's news with the major and top highlights. Let's follow. Back promo 2022 graduation ceremony took place today. And on the international scene, WHO releases its highest level of alert of monkeypox. Those were our major top highlights. Welcome back to our newsroom, our blood viewers. The Prime Minister and Acting Head of Government, Mr. Abdul Ghadir Kamil Mohammed, granted mid-morning in his office a lunch of honor and audience to His Excellency Mohamed Erki, Ambassador of the Democratic and Popular Republic of Algeria. The meeting between the Prime Minister and Acting Head of Government, Abdul Ghadir Kamil Mohammed, and the Ambassador focused on ways and means to further consolidate the existing relations of friendship and cooperation between the two brotherly countries. On this occasion, the Algerian diplomat Mohamed Erki said he was honored to meet with the Prime Minister Abdul Ghadir Kamil Mohammed and thanked him for the warm welcome. The Prime Minister Abdul Ghadir Kamil Mohammed has assured his host of all necessary cooperation and availability during his diplomatic mission in Djibouti. The Minister of National Education and Vocational Training, Mr. Mustafa Mohamed Mahmoud, organized today at the Kempinski Hotel a great ceremony dedicated to the awarding of diplomas of the baccalaureate of the year 2022. This year, the MFOP wished to pay tribute to the commitment of Mrs. Medina Mohamed Roble, inspector who had dedicated her entire professional life to serve the education and training of the young generations with skills, dynamism, responsibility, courage, and love of work well done. Indeed, during her brilliant career as a teacher, pedagogical advisor, inspector, and technical advisor to the minister, she was very committed to the development of the Djiboutian school. She had adamantly demonstrated by her actions the taste of the effort by leading a professional life, a family life, and a perpetual renewal of her intellectual formation. Upon his arrival at the site, the Minister of National Education and Vocational Training, Mr. Mustafa Mohamed Mahmoud, was warmly welcomed by folk dances and the lords of the class who cheered upon his entry into the ceremony room. The ceremony, rich in color and music, was attended by the Minister of Education, Mustafa Mohamed Mahmoud, the Minister of Decentralization, Mr. Qasim Haroun, the Minister of Communication, Mr. Radwan Abdullahi Bahdan, the Minister of Budget, Mr. Usman Rabli, the Minister of Trade, Mr. Mohamed Warsam Adiri, the Minister of Interior, Mr. Saeed Nuh, and the Director of the Sovereign Fund of Djibouti, ambassadors, technical and financial partners of the National Education Partners of Students, and parents of students, and senior officials of the Ministry of Education. This year's baccalaureate 2022 was marked by two historic events. There are the arrival of the first cohort of students from the School of Excellence and the first baccalaureate examination in the interior regions. This is an initiative that completes a series of measures that the Ministry of National Education has put in place to strengthen equity with the education system. Let us all recall that this great ceremony dedicated to the awarding of diplomas of the baccalaureate took place also and simultaneously in the five regions of the interior. As I have mentioned before, this year, MENFOP wished to pay tribute to the commitment of Medina Mohamed Roble, who had dedicated her entire professional life to serve the education and training of the young generation with competence, dynamism, responsibility, courage, and love of work. Well done. Let's follow. One of the graduates with honors from the EFTP, Mr. Abdulaziz, has delivered the speech. Let's listen to him.
Starting with His Excellency, the Minister of Education, Mr. Mustafa Mohamed Mahmoud. My name is Abdulaziz Hassan Abdullahi. I'm 20 years old and I live in Section 3. I am a student of the League.
The Servant Wealth Fund, who spoke at the ceremony first, addressed the graduates and said that the best thing is to have confidence in yourself and always believe in your ability and your capacity to achieve your goals. You try to understand your mental abilities and talents, which should be used well. Everyone at all levels should always aim higher and think about a broader future and education that supports the development of the nation. The Servant Wealth Fund is with you to achieve your educational goals, he specified, especially in the field of investment and finance, and we are ready to support our students and the production of young people with economic knowledge and understanding. I hope you will contribute to the development of the nation and the entire African continent, he concluded. For his part, the Minister of Decentralization, Mr. Qasim Ali Haroun, in his speech congratulated the graduates for their sacrifice and hard work. He said that this event underlined that the decentralization of the baccalaureate test had changed the situation. This novelty is a first in the country and has facilitated so many things for the students. He continued by adding that this is a step that the President of the Republic has given a clear order to bring all government services closer to the people of the region and districts of the country. This step has led to beautiful achievements that have been appreciated in terms of the results of students in the region and educational aids that are at a high level. The results are indeed increasing, he explained. As for the Minister of National Education and Vocational Training, Mr. Mustafa Mohamed Mahmoud, who congratulated the young graduates for the hard work they have done and the efforts made by the entire educational community, teachers and workers, in other ministerial sectors, but also the security corps. He expressed that this day brought great joy and happiness for everyone in the educational community, whether they are parents and students. My feelings today cannot be explained, and I am very happy about the two aspects of our graduation ceremony in this new year, namely the first student of the School of Excellence who is among the graduating students this year, and the decentralized exams, which were the first time students from the region could take the tests without leaving their place of residence. The School of Excellence was born from the President's desire to offer high quality and select our gifted students to find the right school to support their talents and intellectual abilities. The Minister has once again congratulated the students and wished them success and a bright future ahead of them. After the official speeches, the Minister of Education, Mr. Mustafa Mohamed Mahmoud, the Minister of Decentralization, Mr. Qasim Haroun, members of the government, the Director of the Serving Fund of Djibouti, ambassadors, technical and financial partners of national education, and parliamentarians have proceeded to rewarding of the first 20 graduates of the class of 2022, known as Medina Mohamed Roble. Let's follow.
Il y a tellement de qualité. Monsieur le représentant de l'UNICEF, vous avez remis. Voilà. Madame l'ambassadeur. T'applaudis. La photo, maître d'éducation, est nombreuse, excusez-nous. Voilà, chef d'établissement. Yassine, proviseur de lycée PK.
As we have seen, it was an amazing atmosphere. And our reporters have interviewed one of the graduates who has given us their reaction after the graduation ceremony. Let's hear it.
My name is Mabruk Ahmed Ali, and I'm very happy to be here today. It was a great day. It was very beautiful. It was nice, and I was feeling great. Like, everybody was here, like, cheering for us. It's our day. And I can't describe what I'm feeling right now, but I don't have words, but you can see the joy in my face. So, thank you.
We certainly see the joy in your face. To give us more details about this, we got Ibrahim Abdullahi with us, an English teacher from the High School of Gabot. So, Ibrahim, will you present yourself?
Thanks for your warm welcoming, my dear Dini. Mm-hmm. I'm Ibrahim Abdullahi, a teacher of High School of Gabot. I'm so happy to share that edition for you with you. And I will try to say teaching is a beautiful thing. So if you like teaching, it's the time to choose as a profession. That's my message.
Absolutely, absolutely. Yeah. So, Ibrahim, I will be asking you a few questions so that you can clarify us more about the ceremony.
Okay, of
it's
course.
All good?
Yeah.
Okay. So, can you tell us what is the specificity of this year's baccalaureate?
The uniqueness of the baccalaureate 2022,
yeah.
It was a very overwhelming ceremony, and it's corresponding to the 45th anniversary of our country independence, which coincide also to the 45th celebration of baccalaureate in our country. So the Ministry of Education has to participate in that event by reaching 72% of success. So we can see that they make a lot of work, hard working. And in, as you know, in 1977, only 7 people succeed. And now more than 1,000 succeed every year. So you can see the difference and how it's evolved and growing our system, our educational system. That's the point, the first point. The second point is about decentralization. Mm-hmm. It's an essential point, and it's contributed to the originality of this baccalaureate 2022, because it's the first time that all the entire the region holded the examination of baccalaureate.
Yeah.
And the third, the last point is about the first promotion of school of excellence who mm-hmm. participated to the examination of baccalaureate, and they did something very amazing and beautiful. 100% succeeded with honor. So you can see the desire of excellency was done in that moment.
Exactly, exactly. We've all seen that moment. It was very, it was an historical moment, we can say.
Yeah.
So the baccalaureate has been decentralized this year.
Yeah.
What are the impacts?
The impact can be several things,
Okay.
The first aspect is economical and social aspect.
Mm-hmm.
Parents do not have to worry about the safety and the security of their children. So they are in their region. So they are not going to travel to the capital city. The second one is about parents do not have to pay their journey in the capital. So economically, they have not to expense. And the other idea is about a psychological aspect. It's about students. It's students are relieved about the stresses for the informal environment. Because when you come to the capital city and you come from Obok or Tichora, it's not easy to acclimate to the life of Djibouti. Mm. How to take the bus, when to take, where's the school? Mm-hmm. So psychologically, student was relieved about the stress.
Mm.
And the other point is the increasing, It increased because if you compare to the last year to the this year, you can see 8% of increasing of success of the students, So it's a point that we have to emphasize. And the, finally, we can give a message, as I think it's my own opinion, to the other ministry to participate to the decentralization and to implement all the different needs of that people living in the region.
Mm-hmm.
So the education, it's done. It's already given to the students or the parents for that region. So it's time to the other access to have it.
All right. Last but not least, we have all seen the ceremony that took place today. Can you tell us more about the organization of the baccalaureate ceremony?
Okay, the organization was very, very, very overwhelming.
Mm-hmm.
People was enjoying, laughing. Even the minister assert in his speech that he can express his feeling. So we can see when the head of the minister say that, how we can think about others, teachers like us, advisors, students, all the people was delighted. they feel, what can I say, a sense of accomplishment. Mm. That's the first thing. And the second thing is a sense of nostalgia.
Yeah.
Okay? When you lose a predominant person like Medina Mohamed Roble,
yeah.
So you have to dedicate that kind of, event to her.
May God have mercy on her soul.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And finally, we can see that our future, it's not lost yet. Because when you see all these students get their baccalaureate with honor, we can see that the future is already,
secured.
Secured, exactly. Promising.
Yeah, exactly. Okay.
That's the idea that we can say about the ceremony of today.
It's actually a promising idea. It's wonderful. We've all seen it. All right. Thank you, Mr. Ibrahim, for briefing us with the details.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. All right. The Ministry of Budget, in collaboration with the Ministry of Interior and the Ministry of Commerce, organized this morning at the Kempinski Hotel an interministerial meeting whose objective is to strengthen the fight against smuggling. This meeting is part of strengthening and raising awareness of the operation against smuggling. This meeting was chaired by the Ministry of Budget, Mr. Ismail Ibrahim Roble, and saw the participation of the Ministry of Interior, Mr. Said Noor, the Ministry of Trade, Mr. Mohamed Rasamadiri, General of the Armed Forces, General Zakaria Sheikh Ibrahim, the Director General of Customs, Mr. Gulaid Ahmad, Colonel of the Coast Guard, Colonel Wa'is Umar Bogari, the Director General of the National Police, Mr. Abdurrahman Ali Kahin, the five prefects of the region of interior, and the heads of the corps of the five regions. Let us recall that smuggling harms the economy of our country, and without the complicity of a potential buyer, the trafficker could not exercise this illicit trade. It is therefore incumbent upon each citizen to lead this fight on his side to put an end to this scourge. The Mount Jonathan Camp hosted this morning of Sunday, July 24, 2022, a ceremony of promotion to high rank of soldiers who have shown bravery. Chaired by Lieutenant General Zakaria Sheikh Ibrahim, Chief of General Staff of the Armed Forces, this colorful ceremony was attended by Brigadier General Tahir Ali Mohammed, Chief of Defense Staff, Colonel Abdurrahman Ali Kahin, Acting Director General of the National Police, and highest officials of the Djiboutian Armed Forces. On his arrival, General Zakaria Sheikh Ibrahim, accompanied by General Tahir Ali Mohammed, was welcomed by Colonel Muhammad Wa'is Abani, Major of Garrison and Commander of Camp Mojoin. Then the SEMGA carried out the review of the troops composed of a section of honor of the personnel of the regiment of the section general to pay the honors. Faced with an unfortunate situation, the soldiers of Camp Mojoin, with an unparalleled professional conscience, spared no effort to be up to the mission entrusted. Their dynamism, bravery, and strong sense of duty were decisive for the success of this mission, which was remarkably appreciated by the military command. Thus, proud of the work done, the Chief of the General Staff of the Armed Forces wanted to pay tribute to them through this day and urge them to continue in this noble way that honors the whole of the ADF. Once the general was installed and sat down, the ceremony started with the reading of some verses of the Quran al-Kareem by Captain Muhammad Amin. Then Colonel Muhammad Wa'is Abani, Major of Garrison and Commander of the Corps Mojoin, expressed his deep thanks as follows.
لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها لها ما كسبت وعليها ما اكتسبت ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين صدق الله العظيم.
Then Colonel Muhammad Waiz Abani, Major of Garrison and Commander of Commotion, expressed his deep thanks to the Chief of General Staff of the Armed Forces for having honored this ceremony with his presence. Because of their bravery, the military command has decided to see them as an example. To this end, Lieutenant Colonel Nidal Ghalib Mughbil, head of the first bureau, read the letter of congratulations initiated by the Chief of General Staff of the Armed Forces. Thus, the ceremony was an opportunity to reward the lawyers who have distinguished themselves by their decisive role. The lower-ranking soldiers were able to benefit from an exceptional promotion to further motivate them. The ceremony ended with a hot meal in a good atmosphere, punctuated by patriotic songs of the folk group Harbi. The family photo closed this joyful and colorful ceremony.
غي الوادي مركيان عسكري قلا عرلي غي نولينا غي إبا أوغو دارتون أوغادا حلسان.
The head of the World Health Organization, Tedros Adhanom Ghebreyesus, said Saturday that the monkeypox outbreak currently affecting more than 70 countries is an exceptional situation that requires the declaration of a public health emergency of international concern. Well, by this, our blood viewers, we finally conclude this edition. Thank you for being with us and make sure to tune in later for more. Have a wonderful evening and thank you once again for joining us. Take care.
Welcome to Belém.